Shalom. In a few hours, it's going to be Passover Eve, Leila Seder, here in Jerusalem. And I want to just send you, like a bird, a message from Jerusalem, from Israel, wherever you are, to our friends, the people with which we journey, the journey of hope. I think a lot about what's going to happen. The table is already ready. We have charoset, we have matzahs, we have so many things. We have a heart that's opening slowly and asking what will be different and how will it look this year. But actually, I think about these words that we sing, Kadesh, Urchatz, Kalpas, Yachatz, the words describing all the different chapters of the journey to hope. The Moroccans sing, Kadesh, Urchatz, Kalpas, Yachatz, Magid, Rachza, Motzi, Matza, Marok, Orech, Shulchan, Orech, Tafun, Barech, Alel, Nirza. And there are so many different melodies all around the world to say those chapters. The beginning is just Kadesh, to say the Kiddush, to say how blessed we are that we have arrived to Passover of this year, especially this year, in this moment in history. Urchatz, we clean ourselves, how important it is, and what we learned about it in the past few weeks, and how fortunate we are to be here, washing our hands, feeling them, blessing, not in words, but this year especially, just starting the first moment of washing our hands deep inside our hearts with a gratitude that has no words. Kalpas, we start with eating something small like hors d'oeuvre. And then really starts the evening. And the first thing we do is to take the matzah, the first one, the middle one, and break it into two. Actually, why would we do that at the very beginning of the Seder? It breaks the whole feeling. But the Admor, the Rebbe of Sochatshuv, who passed away at the beginning of the 20th century, he says that this is exactly the way to start a journey to freedom, a journey to healing, to say the truth. And the truth is that sometimes history brings upon us, in every generation, a challenge we have not seen, we have not foreseen. It arrives to our door and we have to rise to it, to rise to the occasion, as we are all around the world, all nations, all people, and in our little world of the Jewish people too. He says, start with the truth. And that's only the beginning of the journey, because then the other chapter will be a chapter telling you of all the strengths that we all have in entering the brokenness of this moment in history, the narrowness of this moment in history of Mitzrayim, full of fear and a lot of worry and care, sad news, and also much hope for the people we know and love. And our need and our ability and our yearning to give them a back, to hold their back, to support them, to give them kuach and strength. And so this evening, he says, is an evening of strength in which we slowly give words to what are the strengths. And the first one is that we open the door. We're going to open the door twice this evening, at the very beginning, at the very end. We're going to open it, and it might be a metaphoric door this year, and yet we open it. We open it to say we will not begin our Seder evening unless we know that all around us other people can do so. Freedom and healing is the journey of the many, not only of the one. We all are worried not only about ourselves, but about so many people all around us, about one human family that we care for more than in any other time before. And so we say, Kol dichfim. Any person. And I know that so many of us, so many of the people now I think of in my heart, in my mind, are really those people exactly who never start a Seder. And I'm sure in the past days have been so immersed in making sure that people around in the community have food, have any kind of support that they needed. So they too arrive to this evening. The strength of being able to support others and come out of this narrowness, of this Mitzrayim, of this moment, taking care of each other together. Another strength is really the ability to say the story of the Magid, to say the story of this moment. It cannot be more important than now to sit down and say, this is what is happening to us, to give it a name, to say what the challenge is, what it takes from us, what it needs to us. Manishtana, what is different? And what each one of the boys, the sons and the girls and the daughters in our heart, one of the four of them, say, because there are different voices and they're all ours and they're all important in the journey of hope. And to be able to say the story of fear and then the story of hope and all the assets that we have actually discovered through this story. But there are many other things too, like the fact that we cry. We put a bowl with water and salt, and we dip things into it throughout the evening, and we allow ourselves to be strong enough to cry, strong enough to be weak, to be vulnerable, to say how frightening this is. And this is, he says, one of our strengths. And another strength is our ability to eat after that, to sit and eat slowly, benachat, as people who are coming out to freedom, finding a way to sit down, to take the time to eat, more than anything else, to be nurtured by God himself and the mercy of the divine, as if it were manna in our mouth, a medicine of hope. Now that we put it inside, healing us, a medicine of freedom, giving us the choice to be free even now more than ever. And another strength we have is that we sing loud and clear. Chad gadia, echad mi yodea. We sing. Sometimes I feel I don't even know how to sing, but I sing on Passover evening. It's not only for ourselves. It's for people in different places, different stories. Maybe some of them don't even have computers at all. They live in such a different world. The world now reveals to us so many gaps and one heart of all of us to each other. And yet, as if we were sending out a bird from Noach's ark, the ark of our people in the flood, in this sedil of a time in history of corona, of a plague, we send a bird of song to sit on the shoulder of someone, on a bed of someone, or next to a table of someone, or just next to his heart or her heart, and give them our freedom to hope for them and for all of us. And then we go on to another strength, the strength of Shira Shirim, of the Song of Songs, saying that some of the healing is simply our love. It also has the force to heal, our trust that we are one body. We are all one body, we are all one heart, and that more than in any other time in history, now we understand how much we care for each other and how it pains us in every place around the globe what happens to our one family. As if it's one family sitting tonight in different tables in different places in the world, but we sing for all of them and we send our love to all of them. We cry for all of them, we eat for all of them. We care for all of them and we open the door to all of them. We here in Jerusalem have written a prayer that we will send to you together with this blessing, with this prayer, this plea from Jerusalem for hope and for the healing of our world. That in the second cup in which we open the door, the cup of Eliyahu Navi, the third cup, in that cup we might be able to ask God to pour his, her healing on all of us, all human beings. From here, from Jerusalem, I pray, El narifanala, El narifanala, El narifanalanu lekulanu. Please God, heal us. Please God, heal us. Please God, heal all of us, our beloved, our one family. There's a bird here in Jerusalem. I can hear it outside. It's beautiful. It glows. It's a bird of hope and of healing. It stays here. It doesn't go anywhere else in our world as it is. It's present. It was always here. Even back then at the flood and all floods that we have gone through, our forefathers and us too now, that bird is waiting. It's waiting to see the flood slowly coming down. But it really is witnessing the best of humanity as so many tonight and in the coming days of Passover, and in so many weeks that came before us and will come after us, our world and human family is full of strength and full of mercy. In Jewish ancient tradition, hope is a medicine. Friendship and brotherhood are a medicine. Love is a medicine. Tonight we gather all medicines, loud and strong, so that we can send them with a dove everywhere it's needed. I send you from here, from Jerusalem, my love and friendship, our partnership. L'shana haba'a b'Yerushalayim ha'bnuya v'abri'a. Next year, Be'ezrat Hashem, God willing, we will meet and hug strong and close again in Jerusalem, a built Jerusalem, a healthy Jerusalem, a Jerusalem of hope and healing. Chag Sameach.